Good morning and welcome to Christians Aren't Sheep, a beginner's guide to meditation. Well, we've been reading in Revelations. We're up to chapter 11. I was just out in the shop here. Yesterday I changed the power steering pump on my truck. This morning I'm just cleaning up a little bit, putting away my tools. And reflecting on what we've been reading. And want to just reflect a little bit more about the basis of this video series, or this my YouTube channel. And it's all based on Isaiah 40, verse 31. All those who wait upon the Lord will renew their strength. They will rise up with wings like eagles. They will run and not be weary. They will walk and not faint. And I believe that's fairly important in the upcoming days. Again, I mentioned that I'm hoping and believing that the rapture happens before all this stuff in Revelations, but if it doesn't, good to be prepared for it. So, let's read chapter 11 this morning. So, the sixth trumpet that had been blown, and the second terror, that happened in chapter 9. We're going to get into the seventh trumpet and the third terror. Then I was given a measuring stick, and I was told to go and measure the temple of God and the altar and count the number of worshipers. Do not measure the outer courtyard, for it has been turned over to the nations. They will trample the holy city for 42 months, and I will give power to my two witnesses, and they will be clothed in burlap and will prophesy during those 1260 days. These two prophets are the olive trees, are the two olive trees and the two lampstands that stand before the Lord of all the earth. If anyone tries to harm them, fire flashes from their mouths and consumes their enemies. This is how anyone who tries to harm them must die. They have power to shut the sky so that no rain will fall for as long as they prophesy. And they have the power to turn rivers and oceans into blood and to strike the earth with every kind of plague as often as they wish. When they complete their testimony, the beast that comes up out of the bottomless pit will declare war against them, and he will conquer them and kill them. And their bodies will lie in the main street of Jerusalem, the city that is figuratively called Sodom and Egypt, the city where their Lord was crucified. And for 3.5 days, all peoples, tribes, languages, and nations will stare at their bodies. No one will be allowed to bury them. All the people who belong to this world will gloat over them and give presents to each other to celebrate the death of the two prophets who had tormented them. But after 3.5 days, God breathed life into them, and they stood up. Terror struck all who were staring at them. Then a loud voice from heaven called to the two prophets, "Come up here." And they rose to heaven in a cloud as their enemies watched. At the same time, there was a terrible earthquake that destroyed a tenth of the city. 7,000 people died in that earthquake, and everyone else was terrified and gave glory to the God of heaven. The second terror is past, but look, the third terror is coming quickly. Then the seventh angel blew his trumpet, and there were loud voices shouting in heaven, "The world has now become the kingdom of our Lord and of his Christ, and he will reign forever and ever." The 24 elders sitting on their thrones before God fell on their faces to the ground and worshipped him. And they said, "We give thanks to you, Lord God and the Almighty, the one who is and who always was, and now you have assumed your great power and have begun to reign. The nations were filled with wrath, but now the time of your wrath has come. It is time to judge the dead and reward your servants, the prophets, as well as your holy people, for all who fear your name. From the least to the greatest, it is time to destroy all who have caused destruction on the earth." Then in heaven, the temple of God was opened, and the Ark of the Covenant could be seen inside the temple. Lightning flashed, thunder crashed and roared, and there was an earthquake and a terrible hailstorm. Yeah, there's a little bit of turmoil happening. So, okay. That was chapter 11. I'm going to get back to cleaning up. You all have a fine day. Don't forget to do an act of kindness for someone. It'll benefit you more than it will them. God bless. Have a good day. Bye for now.